Hey, in this video I want to show you how you can create the iframe data mosh effect and the pframe data mosh effect. So we will create both data mosh effects in Avidemux, which is free, and you can find the download link to Avidemux in the description. So after you click this link you should be here. Now go down here and now you have to select one of these two options. So if you have a 64-bit system you need to download this link, and if your system is a 32-bit system then you have to download this link. My system is a 64-bit system and that's why I have to click this link. Now I've got this downloaded 64-bit zip version and I have to press right click. Now unpack this version by clicking unpack here. And now you only have to open this Avidemux 2 application. So now I want to make this window a little bit bigger, so I click on this button. Then you have to import your video footage by left clicking this little button. Now select your video footage and press open. And now you will see a little pop-up window, but this is not very important, so press no. And the second pop-up window is also not important, so you have to press again no. Okay, now your video is imported into Avidemux. So now it's really important that you go to the video section and change that from copy to MPEG-4 ASP.xvid. Now left click the configure button. Now go to frame and change the maximum iframe interval to the maximum. After that, click OK. And now you have to save your video by pressing this button. So this will be our practice video. Now click on save and you have to wait. And now the export is done, so I have to click OK. And then you have to import your practice video again. So I click on this button and I search for my practice video. Now click open. And here we go, everything is set up for the iframe data mosh effect. So now you only have to change the video type from MPEG 4ASP to copy, and then you see this timeline and these buttons. But the most important information is the frame type, which you see here. So the first frame is an iframe, and I go one frame to the right by pressing the right arrow button. And now you see here it's again an iframe. Then I go another frame to the right, and you see here the frame type is a B frame. So again I go one frame to the right, and you see here the P frame. And that are the only three frame types that exist: P frames, iframes, and B frames. And for the iframe data mosh effect, we only need the iframes. So I go back to the first frame, to frame 0, as you can see here. And as you know, this is an iframe, and our goal is that we delete every iframe from this video. And for this, we need to exclude the iframes from the other frames. And we do this by pressing this little A button. Then we go one frame to the right, and after this, we press the B button. And now you only have to press the delete button on your keyboard. Now we have to go to the next iframe by pressing this little button. And again, I press the A button. Again, I go one frame to the right, and after this I press the B button and I press delete on my keyboard. And now I go to the next iframe and I press again A. I go one frame to the right and I press B. And I press delete on my keyboard. And now you only have to repeat this procedure till the end of your video. The only important thing that you have to be aware of is that your frame type is an iframe. After you deleted every iframe, now you go to this button and you left click this button. And now don't click the save button because you have to add something to your file name. So now you have to write down .mp4. And only after that you have to click save. And again there is a pop-up window and we press no. So now our clip has been successfully exported and we can even watch it. But our problem is that we cannot import this video into DaVinci Resolve. To solve this problem, we have to convert our video file. So go to cloudconvert.com, link is in the description, and I import my file into this website. After this, I press this convert button. Then you download your iframe data mosh effect and the video should look like this. So this was the first of the two data mosh effects, and now I will show you the pframe data mosh effect. So again we have to press this little button to import our practice video. And now we are looking for some pframes. So you can only find those pframes by going to the left or to the right by pressing the left or the right arrow button. So look for a nice frame which is a pframe. So I found this pframe, this looks very sick. So what we have to do now is to exclude this pframe. So I press the A button, I go one frame to the right, and I press the B button. So now this P frame is excluded, and our goal is that we have to copy and paste this P frame for the next couple of frames. So press Ctrl and C, And after this, press Ctrl and V. And now you have to repeat pressing V, but do this slowly and don't copy the frame more than 30 times, because otherwise Vidamax will crash. So after you copied your frame for at least 20 times, you go to this little button and write down a nice name for your video and then write down .mp4. Now click on the save button and again click on no on this pop-up. And as you can see, the P-frame data mosh effect differs from the I-frame data mosh effect. So in the P-frame data mosh effect, the pixel get distorted because of the motion of the video. And the last and only thing that is left is that you have to convert your P-frame video again with cloudconvert.com. So again, press this convert button, and after this you have to download your video, and then everything should work perfectly. Yeah, and that's it. I hope this tutorial has helped you. If so, then you can leave a like or a sub to my channel. And here you can see a playlist in which I explain some other difficult effects for you. Thanks for your attention, stay creative, and bye!